And we're back to Learning Inkscape, and this time I'm going to show you how to create an interlocking lattice logo. These logos are typical for colleges. Let us just simply use SU. I don't want to have a serif font. Maybe I'll just pick Cambria, but I want to have it normal. So when I have thin letters, I'll size it up holding control. Afterwards, go to Path and Object to Path, and then Object and Ungroup. So we've got two individual letters now, and we can reposition them. I'm going to transform these letters. So I'm simply dragging these arrows left, right, up and down without holding any keys. I want to have these overlaps to create negative shapes. Let me go down with the opacity and a fill and stroke. And it's a good idea to align them properly. Let me give that a red color first. And now I'll go to Object, Align and Distribute. So that's our starting point. Let me select the U first. I'll go to Path and use Linked Offset. You get this little node right here and you can drag it upwards to create an offset. It's a good idea to deactivate the snapping for now. So we've got two U elements now, one on the inside and one on the outside. Select the outside one, bring it to the top, and shift click on the S, Path and Difference, and this is basically what we want to have. You can see many of these logos, the overlaps are interlocked, so I want to create that effect here as well. Let me use the Bezier tool and I drag a shape over the center position, so where this offset would be. And it doesn't really matter what shape you've got, so you can transform it easily like this. It's important that you've got the overlaps covered. Let me go down with the opacity and you can see that. So this is the only crucial step when you create this shape. You want to copy that, press and Ctrl D. We've got two letters, so we need two. Select one and then shift click on the outer side of the U and then use Path and Difference. Then again, the outer side of the U, select the S letter holding shift. Once again, Path and Difference. And now we've created these cutouts based on the offset on the top and the bottom, but we haven't done so in the center where we want to create this interlock effect. Now let's select the second letter, in this case the S, and use again Path and the linked offset. When you drag the node up, make sure that you don't have overlaps. You can see that right here, it becomes red. So you want to have a size that fits the gaps, but doesn't produce overlaps. I zoom using the mouse wheel and holding control, and it should be fine. Again, we've got two elements now, this time for the S letter, the outer and the inner. Make sure that you select the right one. I didn't right here. So this is what happens when you select the wrong one. Press Ctrl Z. Make sure that you've got the outer one selected. You may want to zoom in. Then shift click on the element that we've got in the center and then use Path and Intersection. And afterwards we want to use Difference again, but you have to make sure that you've got it in the right stacking order. So in this case, the center element needs to be on top of the U, and shift click on the U and use Path and Difference once more. Afterwards, you can select it all and increase your opacity to 100% again. And that's how you can create these typical interlocked lattice logos in Inkscape. I hope this video was helpful, thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.